Hey guys, Andrew here, and welcome to Doom, Ultimate Doom technically, but still Doom. Yeah, so you may be wondering, this looks a little bit different than what I remember, and it is because it is a little different than what you remember. Because old Doom, this is a little bit different. Old Doom was a little bit not as, what's the word I'm looking for? Just not as nice as current Doom could be. So I went ahead and updated it to be a little bit better looking. Man, this is really tough to get used to. Can I? Okay. Hold on. That's not what I wanted. Let's see here. There we go. Or mouse 3? No. There we go. That's a little bit easier for me. All right. Yeah, so this is exactly the kind of Doom I remember. Yeah, this is good old Doom. This is the way Doom should be. Oops. I don't remember there's a jump button. There it is. All right. Pad Y. Let's do that to be space, and use open will be E. That makes it a little bit easier. There we go. What? Why can't I do that? I thought I opened that up. There it is. Yep. Nice. Look at this shit. Any case, getting back to Doom is, the fact that, secret revealed. Eh. Doom is just such a marvel. It's one of the few games that that truly stands up to the test of time. I think Doom is one of the most modded games in all of history, but that might not really matter because it's been around the longest and has probably like the biggest cult following of anything else I've ever seen. But there's a lot to Doom. Let me tell you that. There's a lot to Doom. And you'd be a fool to underestimate the marvelousness ability of Doom in itself. Look at this. Yeah, so currently what I'm having is I have a couple of HD texture mods that are installed, making things a little bit smoother. I have some other stuff here and there as well. Oh god. Oh god, you survived. Okay. Yeah, I have a couple of HD texture mods. I have updated soundtrack to be a little bit clearer. Same soundtrack, but just in like FLAC version. And then I have I have a smoothing mod on, HD texture mod, and I'm running GZ Doom. It's kind of hard to keep track of what's the name of that. But yeah, GDZ Doom or GZD Doom. It's a Doom mod that makes everything a little bit easier, especially to run in first person, which is kind of the, or to full screen. It's kind of a shit show to try to record this game in, it's a shit show to try to record this game using just DOSBox alone. It turns out that actually DOSBox is not the the best means at which to record let's play content. Who would have guessed? I certainly wouldn't have. I would have never guessed. But apparently it is. So, this is a modern marvel of technology. This fucking shotgun, man, changes the world. Ah, so close. What is holding me back from getting my dreams? Let's see here. So, let's go around and kill people. Yeah, so, for those of you who don't have any experience with Doom, Doom was a game that came out a long time ago. Ooh, ouchie daisies. Doom came out a long time ago on modern PCs, Windows NT to be exact. And it was, it was, the first of its kind, that's for sure. It didn't have freeform aiming, which is why you can't see me aiming up or down. It did not use the mouse to aim, by the way. That is just that's a part of the mod, actually, to surprise some of you. The game itself was, I think, roughly about like $20 or so. I don't think it was like a $60 game, but it certainly is worth every pretty penny that someone would have paid for it. Because boy, oh boy, is it an amazing, amazing game. It's one of those times where you kind of play something and you go like, man, I will never forget this. And Doom was that for me. Doom was one of those games that I will never, ever forget that I've ever owned or ever played. I mean, I could be in the worst state of my entire life. I could be sitting there dying from Alzheimer's and I would still be like, Doom was the best! It's just so memorable and so good. And there's just so much that was going on in Doom that was just above and beyond what you would expect to see in a normal game. This was during a time when, the most violent game that probably existed at the time was maybe a really competitive game of Pong. This was like a first of its kind in terms of just pure, unbridled violence. I don't know how else to describe it. It was just pure violence. Doom had nothing going for it besides that. But that's okay, because it quickly made id Entertainment rise up to a very big, what is it? It gave id very big shoes to fill, and those shoes it did fill to an extent. One of the problems is that, of course, you may remember id Entertainment was the one who went on to make Wolfenstein 3D. They also went on to make Duke Nukem. Duke Nukem was 3D Realms. It only made Wolfenstein and, what's it called? And Doom. But, they started the genre that later became the same one that, Duke Nukem was a part of. They said a lot. The Doom engine is actually one of the most easily ported engines in all of time and space and humanity. You can play Doom on literally anything that has a processor, so to speak. And it is impressive how easy it is. You can find Doom on calculators, you can find Doom on phones, you can find Doom on watches, you can find Doom on even, I think someone even programmed Doom to be on a laptop bar for the new MacBooks that came out. Because Doom is that easy to port onto things. It is one of the best engines that have ever existed. It's not graphically the best, but you don't need it to be graphically the best when it's this optimized, baby. But, so, let's see, what else do I got? Got my hands, got this pistol that has max ammo, got my shotgun. Let's try pistoling some people. Imps. Oh, God. Hey, remember, imps are supposed to be the ones that I was going through and, oh, hello there. Imps were the ones that I was going through and basically slam down, and they were the ones that I would easily shotgun once or twice and then just destroy, decimate, kill with purpose. Ah, got him. What's going on up here? That's what I thought was going on up here. Alright, so max ammo for shotgun is 50. That is the most unfortunate thing I've ever heard in my entire life. Same with this. Same with the fact that there are now shotgun guys just roaming around. Okay, and so what did that unlock? That unlocked this staircase, and this staircase can bring me to a lot of mystical places. Oh god! Well, there's the charging ones you guys probably remember from old, or from New Doom. There's a yellow key. Oh man, it is good to play Doom. Doom just feels good. There's nothing about Doom that I could possibly complain about, except maybe the fact that it is a pain in the ass to get all these mods up and running. I mean, thankfully, we live in a futuristic, intelligent society, so honestly, it's not too bad to get GZ Doom running. And I mean, they have mod launchers and stuff like that. It's just the initial setup process takes a little bit, and it kind of sucks that you have to do all that. But it's worth it for Doom, which is undoubtedly one of the best games ever designed. But yeah, so sorry if anybody was coming here hoping I was going to be doing a blind Let's Play of Doom. I cannot imagine somebody who's managed to spend their entire life immune to the ways of Doom. It is just such a good game that it seems almost insulting to believe that someone could possibly have never played it. It's like, come on, man. Did you even play like a good example of just how impressive this game is that Doom itself spawned so many other games because of its engine being open source and easy to use. So that was another thing too, is that Doom's engine was open source, and it made things a hell of a lot easier for people to make Doom-esque games. And I mean, when open source, obviously they still had a license for it. You couldn't just make games using their software without paying them for it, because it's still an engine they own. But it was an open source engine, which meant you could kind of swap and do whatever the hell you wanted in texture form. So, you saw a lot of games that existed like, let's see, Noah's Ark, that bootleg SNES game that existed, Noah's Ark. That was all thanks to the efforts of id Software's Doom engine. Another game that existed was Chex Mix. If anybody remembers Chex Mix, that was a game. And yes, I remember Chex Mix. I did actually own a copy of Chex Mix at some point. I don't have it anymore. Probably I stopped having it when I stopped using CD drives on my computer a couple of years ago. When the invention, or a couple of years ago, I say, is it flash drives haven't been around forever. Yeah, probably like 10 years ago I got rid of my Chex Mix copy. But, or I lost it, more specifically. But, yeah, so Chex Mix existed. There's a couple other ones. Like I said, Duke Nukem existed because of it. Oh, boy. There we go. And, yeah, a whole slew of games just came into existence simply because of the creation of Doom. And Doom, I think, is one of those kind of games that will just always be a memorable test of time. It'll always stand up as one of those things that you can look to and go like, wow, look at this. I can't believe this thing exists. And people would go, yeah, me neither. That's crazy. Let's see. Take me up, Scotty. It's just this guy up here, right? So where is... I can't remember where the thing is. Damn it. There's a way to get to this orb, and I'm trying to remember how to get to this orb. I want to say it's in here somewhere, but I don't remember where in here somewhere. Ah. There it is. Okay. I just remember it exists. Oh, God. You still survive somehow. I'll take the health, though. Yeah. Get on down here, nasty head. Supercharged. 200 health. Secret revealed. Yeah, you gotta be careful about that, because you never know what could be a secret in Doom. Like that. Everything could be a secret. There are more secrets in Doom than there are secrets in the Vatican. There are just so many secrets in this damn game. And they can range from so many things. Like, look, here's a secret right here that hurts you. But you can get a backpack, and you can open this up, and that opens up another door, and you can, Oh, shit, did not mean to do that. I need to take that off. Why am I not... Am I missing something? What's the, shit, what's the crouch button? Crouch does not have a key. Shift. There we go. I was like, there should be a crouch button. Oh, I still can't get in there. Uh-oh. Did I fuck up and not turn something on? Ah. Huh, I may have fucked up and not turned something on. In any case, yeah, so Doom has a lot of secrets. You should find those secrets for yourself, but more importantly, just be aware there's a lot of secrets to find. You'll never run out of secrets when you're playing the Doom. But yeah, so... Alright, let's get out of this level. It's... Ah, God, I just cannot not look back on Doom fondly. It's just kind of impossible to not feel this sense of... excitement and pleasure and frustration and memories and just all sorts of things. Oh God. Look at this shit. Look at this shit they give you into. Ah. Man, could you imagine playing this game as a kid? Oh, you'd just be having a field day. You'd be like, what the fuck? Just found a secret. And I just killed a bunch of things. And I found another secret! And more armor! And a button! That was the end of a level. Boom. Secrets 57%, by the way. 57% of the secrets were found. Fuck. That's crazy. That's crazy. Alright. We are there. Let's keep going. Oh, this Doom soundtrack is just the best. And these guys, of course, are just throwing their shit all over the place. Look at these guys. They are just non-stop throwing shit everywhere. It's like a gauntlet of death. Alright. Oh, red key, right. But, God, there's just, I'm sorry, there's not much to say about Doom past a certain point. Yellow key, right? Yeah. There's not much to say about Doom past a certain point besides just have fun. Just have fucking fun with it. Just let it all go. Who gives a shit about what it looks like? Who gives a shit about how... Anything. Who gives a shit about anything? It's Doom. Just enjoy yourself. Just live for the moment. Look at this shit. You don't even have to aim. You could be a scrub at video games and you can still do this. Not good. That was another thing that was so amazing about this game, was that it's a shooter where you could shoot people because you didn't have to be damn good at the fucking game to do it. You could be just a regular Joe Schmo, and you could make it in this game. You could survive, because it didn't require you to be some amazing monster. It didn't require you to be some kind of like, I don't know, like superhuman aiming machine. All it required from you, all it asked from you, was you just had fun. The good days. Oh, blue key. Oh, shit. That looks like a way I can go. For a yellow key. Ha. Take that, thank you. That's a red key. And that's a new way to go. Ooh, a demon summoning circle. I could use some of all that stuff. Uh-oh. Oh, boy. I guess that's what happens when you take demons' offerings. They get a little mad at you. And the backpack makes it so you can hold more ammo. Such a blessing. Oh, God. Is that it? All right. I think that's it. Yeah, I think that was all the demons. That was another thing that was super no-no, big no-no at the time, was that a lot of people weren't really happy about the whole satanic imagery shit going on. A lot of demons and devils and murder and mayhem. Oh. I mean, this is what started the, what's it called? This is, oh God. Oh boy. I never know if it's been confirmed or not, because it's so hard to tell what has and hasn't been confirmed when it comes to shit like that. But I think one of the claims that people made was that the Columbine created a map in Doom of their high school. Modding, super easy. It's super easy to add mods to this game. Like I said, changing textures is not a big deal. A lot of companies did it. So I'm not saying obviously that's a plus. Don't try to misconstrue my words. I'm not saying fucking Columbine was a great thing. I'm saying that the ability for a player to be able to just freely alter a game as they so please is great. That's a great way to have, just fair to the player. The player can experience a game exactly how they want to. And that's pretty nifty in my book. Nice. Oh, someone was shooting me from over here. Boop. Wonder what that did. Oh, it opened up this area. I wonder what's up here. Hope it's not more demon shit. Okay, let's use some rocket launcher ammo. Oof. That's what I'm talking about. Now imagine having to take these sprites and reimagining them into something new and exciting and completely different from what you've ever seen before in your life. That took some effort. Alright, so now I have the blue key. I'm going to take some of that ammo because I'm running a little bit low. You guys are just never getting out of there, are you? I could kill them if I wanted to, honestly. I can. Nothing stopped me. Ah, the invisibles. Right, forgot about the invisible guys. Ooh, that was a little too close for comfort. I am actually dying. I need to be a little bit more careful here. Alright. And now you know where Turok got its jumping system from. Yes. Ah, look at that. Whew, chainsaw baby. The only difference is that Doom did it better than Turok. Ow. All right. Oh. Shit. I died. Uh-oh. So not a... Fuck. Do I have to do a new game? Yeah. It's not gonna automatically restart me. Well, I ended up dying because I fucked up and I wasn't paying attention to my health. I thought my armor was my health and my health was my armor. My bad. So, I guess I'm gonna go ahead and say thank you guys for watching. If you'd like to see, go ahead and click subscribe. Otherwise, leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me the worst Doom player you've ever seen before. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and
bye!